So, hello, welcome to my channel. This is a new Hyperlab stabilization tutorial, a sequence which a colleague from the internet has some trouble, but it's okay, we will try to stabilize it. I'm just downloading the files. Okay, got it. Just take this out to the desktop. So here it is. Let's see how it looks. This is from Vladimir. I hope we can solve this. And here we go. It's from February. Oh, you were outside in this cold? Very good. Like it. Of course, it's a little smaller just for demonstration. He sent me the files in less than 1 megabyte, and with this high resolution I hope it will not be a problem. Otherwise you can send me the files again and we will look if there can be something improved. But as long as the resolution is the same, you can just apply your stabilization on a better quality sequence. It's no problem. Okay, it's just sometimes a problem if you track manually, then you should have the highest resolution to determine the exact pixels. You know, the first picture is 2:49 p.m. and the last picture is 3:04. So it's only 11 minutes until 3. And 4 minutes, about 15 minutes for 300 pictures. And guess what? This just was a quick hyperlapse. Maybe he did it handheld or with a tripod, but very, very quick. And this is why we have some shakes here, maybe, which aren't so easy to stabilize, right? And it's hardly okay. This goes from right to the left. We can already see it's going from right to left. He moves from the right to the left. We have 15 minutes for 300 pictures. So if we 15 multiplied with 60, 900 seconds. 15 minutes is 900 seconds. So we have 303 pictures divided by 900 seconds. No. Other way around. We have 900 seconds. Yes, this 900 seconds divided by 303 is 2.97 seconds per picture. This is so fast. This is such a fast one. And when you just shoot so fast, such fast hyperlapses, most of the times the quality suffers a little bit, and not the quality in terms of picture quality, not too much, but especially the quality of smoothness, I mean, right? And we just add this inside here, start batch. Good. Okay, now we can begin. Just open up After Effects. And now File, Import, and here is the footage. Make sure that the sequence options is set to Import a JPEG sequence. And just hit Import. And first of all, with the left mouse button, hold it. Just go to the project window and drag and drop it into your timeline. Well, we just have a look how it looks, right? Okay. So you see, very, very shaky, but the interval is quite okay. And because it's the interval is good, I don't think we should throw this sequence into the trash. It's at least 15 minutes. It was a 15-minute session, And I don't think we should drop this into the bin. We should try to make the best out of it, because it's a decent sequence. I don't think this is too bad. But let us see what we can do with it. Have resolution, as this is a long sequence. It looks like Hamburg. This is Hamburg, right? Vladimir. Yes, this is Hamburg. Dockland. It's called Dockland. Okay. If I knew that, I would introduce it. Dockland. Okay. So we see it's very shaky, but I think we will and should try it. Okay. First of all, what I normally do is such unstable sequences, if I'm sure that the warp stabilizer won't work very good, if I'm sure that the tracker will not be able to track this, I will demonstrate this shortly. Wait, we just go to stabilize motion, right? And magnification a little bit more, and we could just go here and try to have this spot here, this exhaust chimney, and may say stabilize one frame forward. I hope you can see this. Stabilize one frame forward. Okay, it worked, and it will keep this exhaust thing as its target. And in the first picture, well, it was the same spot. Okay, cool. Continue. And what I found out is, if you do this button, it's not so accurate than if you do it frame by frame. If you want to play around, if it's not working, you can go to options and say channel, RGB, luminance, and saturation. You can switch off and switch on the subpixel positioning. You can say, please adjust the feature only if the thrust is under 3% or 80 by default, right? You can just play around with the features and see if there are any better results, right? Just continue. We have half the sequence stabilized. All right, then apply X and Y. Good. Okay. Now it's pre-stabilized. Normally, when I'm really sure that the tracker won't work, I just go, let me say, file, import, and we just imported this. Okay, here a new sequence, right? This is completely unstable again. And we just would say, go to this triangle, this play button, say transform, and say position, scaling, and rotation. And then I would just say view lines, and make sure the lines are visible by presettings, and grid and help lines. And we change the color to what's visible very good, a black maybe. Okay, well, okay, a black is okay. And we would just say here, or even better here, this is more defined, and I mean this. And by pressing the space bar, you can scroll around. And we would just say like this, and make sure it's not applying on your helping lines, it's just completely free, right? And this is how we would stabilize it, or let's better say pre-stabilize it before applying the warp stabilizer. But as you have seen, this is not necessary, as the motion tracker completely or almost completely did a good job by tracking this antenna, or I don't know I'm not a ship expert. I don't know what it is. We go back to our sequence here, and it made a quite good job. We just show the half of the resolution, and let's see what the tracker did. What was this? There was something. I saw something. I'm not sure if I'm wrong. There it is. There. Okay. Okay. Okay, well, fine. A little bit better. And if you just increase the speed, you really do not see that it's really, really unstable anymore. If you just increase the speed, you could say, no, it's okay. But the second tracker will be a little bit harder to stabilize. Go to the second tracker for rotation. I know, of course, we of course should stabilize in here or in here, but what I think, because of the 15 millimeters, in terms of lens distortion, this is really not solvable, rescuable. You really cannot rescue your lens distortions. That's not possible. At least with the trackers, not. You know what I mean? Because we have a 15 millimeters, it's not a good idea to track the points which are very far, far away from each other. We want to concentrate on the middle of the picture and try to at least rescue the inside, the center of the picture. With this it did not work, but with this it did work, right? So sometimes it's better to save the time and make it manually than to mess around with the automatic mode, which you have to correct very often. Doesn't make sense. Let's see how it looks. Then we just, with the left mouse button, we hold and drag and drop it inside this little film symbol. And let's see if the warp stabilizer can help something. Subspace warp in this case, because we want to warp and stretch and deform the sequence pictures. Just say 1% and try what it does. Okay, let's see what the warp stabilizer did to this sequence. Looks a little bit better. So, last chance is to stabilize it again with the warp stabilizer. In order to do this, we have to drag and drop that into the third one. And here we name it. Yes, warped 2 times. And we press warp and detailed analyzes, stabilize only, is finished. We just watch how it looks. Not really better at all. And that's because the side areas with the 15 millimeters, it's too much distorted. You can stabilize whatever you want in the middle, but all of the edges will just jump and bump again. Just adding a new null object, say 0, and say transform. Transform. Okay, okay, let's try this. Let's try to move this more and this. I display the lines and try to stabilize this like that. Edges are too much to the sides. You see, the middle is roughly stable, but okay. The next step would be to delete all pictures which are too much unstable and then try it again, right? As much as I know, I basically did all what I would do normally. So I hope, Vladimir, that you will get this stabilized again. Just delete all pictures which are too much to the right or too much to the left, and let, like, from the 303 pictures, just delete as about 100 pictures or so. And the remaining 200 ones, you could try this again. Okay, bye bye.